everyone, and welcome back to Relax My Dog. I'm Patty, and today I'm going to do a short like Q&A thing, but no one's asked questions, so I've just made up some myself. So I'm just going to answer about 5 or 6 of the most commonly asked questions about dogs. So these are just some simple things that could help guide you when you first get your dog, knowing what to do and what not to do if it is your first time. So let's get started with the Q&A. So the first question is, how often should I feed my dog? So that obviously depends on its size. Obviously bigger dogs eat more than smaller dogs. It also depends on age. So some puppies like to have smaller meals more frequently. So one breakfast, lunch and dinner, just like humans, well, some humans. And they have smaller portions, and this just helps their digestion because obviously they've only got little bellies. Oh, they've only got little bellies, so they can't fit much in there. But they are growing, so they do need a constant supply of nutrition, so you need to be giving that to them. And then when they are around, I would say about 3 months old, then you can reduce it to 2 times a day. Obviously it depends on your dog. Some dogs do better on 2 meals a day, some do better on 3 meals a day, but there will be guidelines on the pet food packaging about how much you should be giving your dog, and if you are still unsure, then it's a good idea to ask your vet. So the next question is, how many walks you should give your dog a day. So obviously this is size dependent as well, but you can get small dogs that are crazy and need about 3 million walks a day. Maybe not that much, but for example, the Chihuahua is the smallest breed in England, but it is like a big dog in a small dog's body, so it still needs a lot of walks. So I would say keep in the back of your mind, if you have got a bigger dog, it would need more walks. However, it is dog dependent, and you will know if your dog needs a walk because it will start being a lot more unruly than usual. And some dogs look at their lead like it's like Pongo out of Dalmatians, where he grabs the lead and takes it to the owner. Some dogs literally will do that, so you'll know when they need a walk. But yeah, I just say just trust your instincts and just try and walk them as much as you can. Okay, so one of the questions we got on the competition video was, how to stop your dog chasing cats. So this is quite a hard one because it's an instinct that they just go. So if you've got them off the lead, then maybe not have them off the lead in an area you know cats will be, because once they're off the lead and they see a cat and it's all like guns blazing, they've gone, there's no stopping it from there. But try and keep them on the lead, and then when you have got them on the lead, if they're being really good around a cat, if you are clicker training it, then click then, or just give them loads of praise. And then if they start showing signs that they want to chase the cat, just say no in a very fair voice, don't shout at them, and just guide them onto where they should be walking, not walking towards the cat. So the next question is, how much does a dog cost? Again, this is size dependent, so obviously a bigger dog needs more food, so it will cost more. However, the average cost of a dog is about £1,200 per year. I know, it is crazy. But if you want to get a dog, it is something to bear in mind. Do you have these funds to spare every single year? Because you can't cut back on your dog's needs, and you need to make sure that you do have this money available. So it is a reason why a lot of people can't get a dog, but it is best to let you know before you get one and not realize, and then it ends up in a shelter. The next question is, can dogs live in apartments? So yes is the short answer, they can, but again, this is breed dependent. Some breeds are crazy and will just not be happy in an apartment. A lot of dogs do need a garden just to run around and let go of some steam, but it is possible to keep a dog in an apartment. So just do your research and try and find a less active breed. Obviously, when dogs are puppies, they're always gonna be active. You're never gonna get one that is completely quiet and just sleeps all day. You might get a few, and obviously puppies when you first get them will sleep all day, but eventually when they're about 1 year old, they are going to be a little bit crazy. So no matter what, you need to be prepared to deal with that, and if you do get a quiet one, then you're lucky. But yeah, they can live in apartments. Just be aware that at first you're going to have to be going out a lot to train them to go to the toilet outside, and there will be accidents. And also make sure that your landlord allows it, because you won't want to get one and then your landlord says no, because that would be a very awkward situation. So that is the end of this short Q&A. If you have any more burning questions that you need to ask, then comment them below and I will do another Q&A shortly if we get enough. So hopefully you have enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!